Well, calls for Israel's destruction aren't limited to the Muslim world. They can also be heard here in our nation's capital. Hey, we let Anwar al-Awlaki preach here, so why not? In this Stackelbeck on Terror exclusive report, we introduce you to a Pennsylvania college professor who led the charge at a recent anti-Israel rally in D.C. Get ready to be shocked. The flags carried the logo of the terror group Hezbollah. The rhetoric was the kind you'd normally hear in Tehran or Gaza. Yet this scene occurred just minutes from the White House.
We must stand united to defeat, to destroy, to dismantle Israel, if possible, by peaceful means. Perhaps like Salahuddin, we will give them enough food and water to travel back to the land from the way they came to occupy our people.
The speaker's name is Kawkab Siddiqui. He's an associate professor of English at Lincoln University in Pennsylvania. He used his time outside the classroom over Labor Day weekend to address an annual gathering of radical Muslims and leftists about Israel.
For the Jews, I would say, see what could happen to you if the Muslims wake up. And I say to the Muslims, dear brothers and sisters, unite and rise up against this hydra-headed monster which calls itself Zionism.
Ray Locker's group, the Investigative Project on Terrorism, captured footage of Siddiqui's Washington rant.
And this is something that he has said at similar events over a period of at least a dozen years, as far as we can tell.
CBN News found email exchanges posted online in which Siddiqui called the Holocaust a hoax that was invented, saying there is not even one document to prove it happened. He's also written that Jews have taken over America by devious and immoral means. Despite a history of anti-Semitic statements, Siddiqui maintains a job teaching literature at Lincoln University and sits on at least two school committees. Lincoln is the nation's oldest historically African-American college. Since 2003, it's received almost $200 million in Pennsylvania state money towards various projects. Now, Lincoln University administrators declined to appear on camera, but the school's executive vice president told us they in no way agree with or support Siddiqui's comments on Israel. But he added that Siddiqui is tenured, has freedom of speech, and Lincoln cannot control what he does or says on his own time as a private citizen. Siddiqui has also advocated for two convicted terrorists with ties to al-Qaeda, including the cleric behind the 1993 World Trade Center bombing.
It's one thing to have strong beliefs. It's another to advocate violence, go to bat for people who are established terrorists.
Siddiqui declined CBN's request for an on-camera interview. But in an email response to our questions, he denied that he was anti-Semitic, saying his comments on Israel conform to the ideals and principles that founded Lincoln University. He added, "When I refer critically to the Jews, I am referring to the current leadership of the State of Israel and to their major supporters, not to the Jewish race as a whole." His recent statements in Washington, however, appear to suggest otherwise.
The Quran says, drive them out from where they drove you out. There's no question of just removing the settlements. These settlements are only the tentacles of the devil who resides in Tel Aviv.
Now, Lincoln University administrators say their hands are tied and there's nothing they can do about Dr. Siddiqui because he makes his genocidal statements outside the classroom. Which raises the question, if a Lincoln professor was, say, an open member of the KKK or Nazi party, in their free time, of course, would they also still be welcome on campus? I'm waiting for an answer, Lincoln. This isn't going away.